Hello guys, welcome to Cognitive Hub VBA tutorials. In today's video, I am going to discuss about how to insert a checkbox and how to write a macro code and how to assign a macro code for it. Now, without wasting any time, let's dive into the topic. So this is the spreadsheet that I opened naming this checkbox, and here we have a lot of options to insert any type of button. In the previous lecture, I already showed you about how to insert a command button and how to assign a macro to it and how to write a macro code and all. But in this lecture, I am going to explain you about how to insert a checkbox and how to assign a macro. So first of all, you need to enable the developer option, and once you click the developer option, click to go to insert button here and go to checkbox here, and then simply drag and drop here whatever the size you want. And here what happens is, by default the checkbox is the name that you have. If you want to edit text, then you can write whatever the name that you want. Like what I am writing is, I am first of all deleting the context here, checkbox example. This is the just a name that I am giving. Sorry, I am just increasing the text here. So I changed the text here, and I am going to assign here also the event is on click event, just like the previous button. Whenever you clicked on the button, the button will get executed the corresponding macro code. Here also, whenever you tick the checkbox, the corresponding code will get activated. Here the macro is checkbox new one, and I am creating a new macro code here, so it directly opens the checkbox. So I am just writing a simple code that will execute, that will show how it will get executed when you click the checkbox. So what I am doing is message box. I am just writing a message box, and I am writing it like, hi, this is checkbox example. So I am saving it and going to the spreadsheet, and now I am checking it. See, whenever I check, it is getting hi, this is the checkbox example. And whenever I unclick also, it will get affected because it is also a click event, but here I am unselecting the checkbox. So that is how it will get executed whenever you click that checkbox or unclicking that checkbox. So this type of examples will mostly useful when you want to do some particular operations only if that particular checkbox is activated. Like for suppose, if you want to copy some data to other spreadsheet, or to sort out some particular data based on the category that they selected. So at that point of time, this type of checkboxes will get used. And here the event is also the on click event. So thank you guys, that's all for this video.